So anytime that you're discussing joint classification, a lot of times you focus more on the functional, but it's important to understand that different joints are going to allow different types of movements. Now there's a lot of jargon associated with joint movement classification, so similar to the function, really pay attention to these terms and understand the differences between them. Okay, so as we discussed, there's three main types of movement classifications. There's the immovable joint, so absolutely no movement or movement is allowed at that joint. We refer to these as a synarthrosis, okay? So syn, no, means no, okay? The two main types, you'll have your sutures, and this is only in adult sutures, because recall, juvenile sutures, you do need some movement in order to allow the brain to grow. And then also in terms of synchondroses, so those epiphyseal plates where you'll have the replacement of bone once bone length growth has finished. Okay, the second type, and the one that's a little bit more difficult to understand, is the amphiarthrosis. These are slightly movable joint, and you'll see that in all the textbooks. You'll see slightly movable. Slightly movable means barely movable. Very, very little movement is allowed here. But it's not, say, like a suture where there's absolutely no movement. Just very, very slight movement. So you'll have these associated with the interosseous membrane between your radius and your ulna, as well as between your tibia and your fibula, as well as those secondary cartilaginous or symphyses. These are another example of amphiarthrotic joints. Lastly, you're going to have your freely movable joints. Now, some diarthrotic joints are going to be more movable than others. If you think about your ball and socket joints, so ball and socket joints, you'll have two main ones of those. You'll have your shoulder joint as well as your hip joint. Those are freely movable. They move in multiple axes. You have different types of actions that are allowed there. Whereas if you think about a hinge joint, really you're only having movement in one axis. But compared to the other types of joints, the ones that we just discussed, there's a lot more movement there than in those other ones. So they're still considered freely movable joints. So this comes to one of the most important concepts when you're talking about joint, and specifically joint stability. If a joint is more mobile, it is inherently less stable. So if you think about your shoulder joint, this is the most mobile joint of your body. It is highly movable. You can move it in many different directions, but it's also your least stable of joints. And anytime that anything's less stable, that is going to be of clinical importance because you typically have more injuries in those areas. Whereas if there's less mobility, say no mobility, that's more stability. So if you think about your sutures, no mobility whatsoever, very stable joints. But there absolutely no movement is allowed there. So you have this kind of give and take between mobility and stability that can have implications clinically.